The Cameron Peak Fire near Rocky Mountain National Park has become the largest wildfire in Colorado history, growing to almost 207,000 acres this week. The fire was 55% contained as of Wednesday afternoon. It was quickly joined this week by the East Troublesome Fire to its southwest. Over a period of 24 hours, the East Troublesome Fire grew 6 times in size to more than 125,000 acres as of Thursday. The blaze, which is burning at an elevation of 9,000 feet and across both sides of the Continental Divide, forced Rocky Mountain National Park to close. It's now the fourth largest fire in Colorado history. The previous record holder before Cameron Peak was the 137,000-acre Pine Gulch Fire near Grand Junction, Colorado. That fire also ignited this year and was declared 100% contained in September. It only held on to its record as Colorado's largest wildfire for 7 weeks. 3 of the 4 largest wildfires in state history have ignited just since July. Yet another fast-moving wildfire ignited in Boulder County on Saturday and quickly spread across almost 10,000 acres, forcing at least 3,000 people to evacuate. Known as the CalWood Fire, it's now the largest wildfire on record for Boulder County. Then on Sunday, the Lefthand Canyon Fire started just outside of Boulder. Beyond the threat from the flames, these various wildfires have sent dangerous, smoky air into cities like Denver and Fort Collins, triggering air quality alerts off and on for months. Together, the recent blazes in Colorado add up to an unusually long, late, and severe wildfire season, and it's not likely to let up anytime soon. "The current fire season, it's definitely a crazy one," said Chad Hoffman, an associate professor of fire science at Colorado State University. "We still have dry, windy conditions pushing these fires. Some unique weather conditions this year set the stage for Colorado's blazes, but the threat from wildfires is growing across the state due to human development and climate change. What's fueling Colorado's fires this year? It's an increasingly familiar story. Like the epic wildfires this year across California, Oregon, and Washington, the wildfires in Colorado arose amid a year of extreme heat and dryness. Heat waves baked the state this summer and persisted into the fall. The high temperatures increased the evaporation of moisture from vegetation, leaving plants dry and ready to burn. There was also less rainfall. Over the past month, precipitation was less than 10% of what is typical. By the end of September, nearly 100% of the state was experiencing some level of drought, up from 51% since the beginning of the calendar year, according to the Colorado Climate Center's monthly State of the Climate report. The state is on track to have its second-driest year on record. That aridity has left almost every type of vegetation in the state prime to burn, as was evident in the Cameron Peak Fire.